next match on court one. Our court will be Jan Jorgensen, the number six seed from Denmark, up against the youngster, the left-hander, Kento Momota. Japan. Momota turning 19 12 days ago. Up against the 25-year-old. There's the 25-year-old Dane from Aalborg in North Jutland. And here, the reigning world junior champion, Kento Momota. Japanese player has had so far. In the very first round, he beat the number four seed, Tommy Sugiyato, who of course was winner of the Singapore Super Series event and quarterfinalist at the recent World Championships, beat him in two straight games. Then defeated Chen Yukion of China in yesterday's match. Needed three games now and 7 minutes for that. Well, he's up today in this quarterfinal against another World Championship quarterfinalist, Jan Jorgensen. Well, Tai Wei is our umpire for this one. Well, Jan Jorgensen has been in scintillating form so far here in Changzhou. First two matches in two straight games. In the first round against Yan Hao Wei, who of course was winner of the Australian Grand Prix Gold earlier this year, and in the process beat the world number one Li Chong Wei in the semi-final. So that young Chinese player has showed his form already, but he was disposed of 21-17, 21-15 by Jorgensen in round one. Chao Tien Chen of Taipei was his victim in round number two. Can't help but wonder with Momota how much has been taken out of this 19-year-old. With his match yesterday, an hour and 7 minutes. Jorgensen, of course, has been in this sort of big match before, twice a World Championship quarterfinalist. And in fact, a winner of one Super Series title. That was his home event, Denmark, 3 years ago. Whereas for Kento Momota, well, he was a quarter finalist at the Singapore Super Series event, having been promoted from the qualifying event. So for the Japanese youngster, this is his second ever Super Series quarterfinal. Well, there's Kenneth Jonasson, who has returned to Denmark. He was former head coach of the English badminton team and now has returned to Denmark and helping the Danes. Former world number two, of course, Kenneth Jonasson. European champion in 2008. Well, for a man that's only turned 19 12 days ago, on the 1st of September. All goes well for the Japanese left-hander.
Momota to serve.
The first meeting between these two players. Not surprising because Momota. Really, this is first year on the elite level of tournaments in World Badminton. Last year, when he won the World Junior Championships on home soil in Chiba in Japan. Very nice. Momota has certainly had a wonderful start to the year. There he is. First three tournaments of the year, he won them all. Estonian International, Swedish International, Austrian International. And what to say, I think that some of the European teams could learn an awful lot by how the Asians develop their youngsters, put them on the international challenger circuit, then move them up to Grand Prix events, and finally then introduce them to the Super Series. In my opinion, too many European players are thrust straight into the Super Series before they're really ready. The development of this young man seems to be well on course. Athlete is Jorgensen. Nice too.
4-3.
I remember about 4 years ago, world number one, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia, said that he thought that this young Dane would be one of his main rivals in the future. Well, that hasn't materialized yet. Certainly had some outstanding results. As far as players he's beaten Lee Chong Wei, that's in the first round of the China Open back in 2009. Beat Lin Dan in the first round of the Malaysian Super Series. Sorry, it was the second round of the Malaysian Super Series last year, last 16. Four wins over former world champion Chen Jin. So he's had the outstanding results against certain players, but he hasn't really pushed that through and translated it into the sort of tournament results or number of Super Series finals, perhaps that's Lee Chong Wei and others were expecting. Only two Super Series tournament finals so far, only winning the Denmark Open, reached the final of the 2009 China Super Series. So he obviously likes playing here in China. Body language after that rally from the reigning world junior champion, a little bit concerning. Looked a little dispirited and a little tired. Clever. Aiming towards the left shoulder. And for a left-hander, that's very difficult to respond to. You've got to crouch down very low. Crouch down on your haunches and drive the shuttle back. And you're forced to play it with a sort of forehand action, which defensively is the more difficult. Good net shot. What a super net shot from the left-hander. Oh, so much for my theory. He looked a little bit dispirited. None of it. That was nigh on perfect. Oh. which can be deceptive. Back level. 7-all in game. Oh, what a nice net shot. Follows it up well and goes into the lead.
8-7.
Well, certainly when Jan Jorgensen played his World Championship quarterfinal in Guangzhou last month against Tianmin Yun, saved 4 match points in the deciding game. But they're up to 20-all. He seemed to then go so negative. Just wanted to rally, had opportunities to finish off the point. And I wonder if psychologically that's maybe just left a psychological scar. Set up by his movement deep into his backhand corner, moving fast enough that he could still play the shot with what we call the round the head action, still hitting the forehand in essence. That's well taken. Suddenly just upped his intensity. The way I know he can play, which makes his tactics in the World Championships even more bewildering.
Play.
4 straight points.
7-9
from 7-9 adrift to go to the mid-game interval with a 2-point advantage. Interesting little reaction from Jan Jorgensen as well. A little clenched fist, a little hop and a skip. Oh, yes, well, that's very close to racket not pointing in a downward direction. This is his 5th appearance at the China Masters. Jan Jorgensen.
11-9.
One of his previous 4 occasions, 3 times, he's lost in the first round. In fact, prior to this year, after his 4 previous visits,
he was
1-5 as far as the win-loss record was concerned in this tournament. Precision. Block hit the top of the tape, just trickled over.
That's the racket.
And a new racket for the Japanese youngster.
Okay.
Wasn't only gold medalist at the World Junior Championships last year, he was also gold medalist at the Asian Junior Championships.
13-10.
Medal medalist at both those events the previous year in 2011. There's been a steady and good progression in is this left
11, 13.
Very good signs for Japan as well, not only this youngster for the future. Quarter-final stage of the men's singles, four Japanese players. Two of them having to play against each other, Kenichi Tago and Sho Sasaki. Sumasa Sakai is the other one. Make up the quartets. Well taken. Didn't realise it was that close. Control of the front of the court, very, very important in men's singles. Disciplines, to be honest, but even more so, I guess, in men's singles. Getting the tight spinning net shot for first, you force your opponent to lift and lift short, and then you've got the attacking opportunities. Oh, good reactions this time from Kento Momota. Perfect example of what I've just been describing.
15, 13.
Well, unfortunately, we didn't see the tight spinning net shot, but the short lift, you could clearly see from Jorgensen's feet, he was nowhere near the back of the court, and therefore he was able to play the attacking winner. Goodness, that is a good net exchange. Well, it's not only the control. What really impresses me is that a young man who only has just turned 19 has the courage to play that. Very, very good indeed. Demonstration of how important the net area is in men's singles. And the margins between success and failure are absolutely tiny. Found the back line. That was a misjudgment from Jorgensen. Could have played that. Oh, clever, my goodness. Trying to outwit the other. Oh. Yeah. Well, it's a shot that's getting used 18, more 15. And more in men's singles now. The body attack players so good defensively out wide, suddenly hit in the midriff. Well, the more I watch this young man, the more impressed I am. I think it was in the very early stages. I think it was about 5-4 when I made comment that he looked very dispirited after missing a net shot. How wrong I was. And what a good attitude he's shown throughout. Thinking, so creating opportunities, forcing weak replies. Oh, it's just 1 point, isn't it? The body attack once again from Jan Jorgensen that has the desired effect. Clinches his fist. 3 game point opportunities.
Kento Momota. 20 game point 17.
I wonder if he realized just how talented. Open game. And the number 6 seed.
Then 1-17.
21-17. difference a year makes as far as Kento Momota is concerned. 12 months ago, he played in this event and he lost in the qualifying round.
Level.
Quarterfinal.
Play.
Against the vastly experienced number 6 seed, Jan Wolden. Disposed to the number 4 seed, Tom Sugiyato. Dig deep here.
One love.
Almost stop the game. It seemed to be right at the end of that opening game. Yeah, Jorgensen just seemed to get himself a little more fired up. Played with a little more urgency. Consistency, but that will come. It's so difficult with players who don't have the racket skills. And then teach them as they enter their 20s.
5-1.
Those players who've got the skills as teenagers who can make them consistent relatively easily. Instigating the timeout. An hour and 52 minutes he's been on court for his two matches. 20 minutes. Dane's been on court and he has made, I think, quite a big difference, apart from the emotional state of affairs, because, of course, when you have a big win, as Momota did in the first round against Tommy Sugiyato,
5-1.
Second.
Play.
Difficult to lift yourself day after day emotionally, not physically.
Service 6-1.
Looks to me as if Jan Jorgensen is just beginning to stamp his authority in this match. To weather the storm early on in the rally, he was under an awful lot of pressure, and then when he had the opportunity to attack, a nice straight smash, not all power, just going for placement down the line, follows it in and plays a delicate little block, a change of pace for the outright winner. Oh, now, what was it, 3 rallies ago, I said he'd just overdone it, but don't worry,
3-6.
He can become more consistent with that. Perfect. super speed. Two players this week mistiming the shot. It's happened to us all. Dilemma of this overhead because the means that he gives it too much power is going to go on for that line, but they're honestly woefully short.
Sami Sova, 5-8.
Me, there was virtually no backswing of the racket there at all. Oh, so much for my theory that the dame was taking his authority on the match, because it's now
8-4
in this second game. He was 5 points adrift at one stage. Just won 7.
Jorgensen. 9-4.
By the time he played that, it was about shoulder height.
Four.
So clever once again.
Turn 9.
He's deceptive from the front of the court. That left hand, he just holds and then a little flick makes the dame turn and play the high backhand. And of course, you've got to then turn back to face your opponent. That wastes time, you slow back to the base position. Can't see what's happening. And he's found the line, would you believe it?
11-9.
To the mid-game interval with the advantage. Kento Momota, the reigning world junior champion. Oh, only just caught the line. Look from the end. What a comeback. What character. Thought he was cruising, and perhaps he thought he was cruising. That's suicidal in the sport. You've got to play each and every point with the same sort of intensity. It's the most important rally of the match. And its lovely variation of pace and angle. Yeah, it's done it again.
That
was fantastic. Skill, the deception. Downward direction. Momota is very, very impressive. There he is again. Can't tell whether it's going to go down the Dane's forehand side or, as indeed it did, down the backhand. Oh, stumbled. My goodness. Straight with himself. If I get out there and make it happen. No, he's just being reactive instead of proactive.
So it's silver. 12, 17.
notice him sort of just stretching his ankle. Oh, I did wonder whether he had, his ankle had gone or whether it was just a straight stumble. As he came forward to play the shot from the backhand nets, Momota was desperately, desperately slow. He was recovering back to the centre of the court to his base position. Predicted this at 1-6 down in the second game, having lost the first
13-13
advantage. At walking pace.
So it's summer.
This is where Jorgensen gets drawn in to playing negative badminton. He knows that he's probably one of the fittest badminton players in the world. And therefore he just assumes he can run his opponent racket, wear them down. You have to do more than that. Some stage, he's got to finish off the rally. Yes, work them hard. Super shot. The line once again, and it is four game point opportunities for Kento Momota of Japan to level this quarterfinal. Oh, please. Opportunities squandered.
17,
Japan doing well in terms of it. Sayaka Takahashi. Well, Jorgensen doesn't like the call. I'm looking straight down that line. I thought that was perfect. It is indeed one game apiece. Symmetry in the scoreline. Both games. Won and loss, 21-17. So it is one game more in this high singles. Thank you.
Fine again. Level. Play.
So here we go with the third and deciding game.
One club.
19-year-old Kento Momota. From Japan. 35 in the world. Yes, number 6 seed. There's the drift coming into play.
2-1.
Oh, coming towards us. Changed his mind on that. Now is Jorgensen. Oh my God, he's standing his ground. Look at this. Plays the net shot, hovers round the net, ready to take the shuttle off the top of the tape. Great body smash once again. Kenneth Morrison's pleased with that. Attitude.
Play.
Top, top.
Oh, finish off the rally. Looking to play the winner.
Play.
8 straight points. Not to be.
11-3.
Kento Momota. Changzhou has decided again with an 8-point advantage.
What did this mean?
Stand your ground a bit, because then you're forcing to lift, and there's a very good chance he'd lift long. And if you're going to lift from the net, you can afford to keep it a little bit flatter. Don't give him so much time. You're likely to hit
11-3.
Give it a bit of pace deep into those back corners. Position and again. He's looking a lot more relaxed now, is Kenneth Jonasson.
Play.
was making those in the second game was Momota. Lost a bit of belief.
17-5.
It really is all one-way traffic now. It's all in favour of the Dane.
Semi-silver. 6-17.
Points away now, Jan Jorgensen securing his place in tomorrow's semi final.
20 match point to 6.
1 point needed now.
Play.
54 minutes of play. Match points.
Yeah.
Only needed the one, though. 21-6 in the deciding game. Well, perhaps took his foot off the pedal in the second game, Jan Jorgensen, number 6 seed. But let's give credit to the reigning all-junior champion, Kento Momota, because he played some wonderful badminton and gave us a real insight to his potential for the future. He's only just turned 19. We will see an awful lot more of Momota. But tomorrow we will see Jan Jorgensen, because he's booked his place in the semi-final. 21-17, 17-21, 21-6 in the deciding game in a match just a little over 54 minutes. So we turn our attention to women's singles now, and two unseeded players in this quarterfinal encounter. It's Pontipa Boranaporatsotsut of Thailand against Han Li of China. They're the young Thailand player, 21 years of age, I think she'll turn 22 at the end of next month from Bangkok.